when the sky goes dark and you hear the thunder and you're standing up, said I'm running for cover. Raise a voice, hear it echo. Raise a voice, hear it echo.
What's up, everyone? We are so excited that you've joined us here. We're going to have an incredible time of worship and being in His presence this morning. Also, we have a guest speaker, Bobby. He's going to be bringing the word. It's going to be awesome. Youth, a reminder today, we need your help at 2 to set up for the Fall Fest that we have. Please come join us.
Okay, this evening is it. At 5 o'clock, we're going to be having our Harvest Festival. We're going to be having a chili cook-off contest, so bring your best recipes. We're going to be having a costume competition. There will be prizes for the best costume, so dress your best. We're also going to be having group activities and games. It's just going to be a great time for the whole family. So come on out and join us this evening at 5 o'clock.
This Wednesday at 6 o'clock, we've got home groups. If you're not already connected, call the office and we'll get you plugged in.
Hey seniors, this Thursday at noon is our 55 and over game day down in the ladies' Sunday school room. So if you want to participate and play some board games, card games, come and join in with the fun. See you then.
Hey, we only have like 3 Christmas shoeboxes left for you to fill with wonderful toys for kids across the whole world. I need you to have those back by December 15th. That is the deadline, and we've only got a few left, so go get one.
For the month of November, the Oasis needs cornbread mix, cranberry sauce, mac and cheese, canned soup, canned yams, and ramen noodles. Come and drop your donations off on the bin on the back porch.
This November, we have some new prayer cards. There are real needs for real people that really need your prayer. Go back to the back porch, pick one up, and pray for them. Okay, we still have Trinity face masks for sale out on the back porch. They are $6 a piece. And if you've already ordered your face mask, you can go back there to pick them up.
Hey church, condolences go out this week for Carol Noble and his family. The passing of his wife, Kate, this past weekend. Just be in prayer for them, their family, and just pray that the Holy Spirit would get them through this time of loss. Thank you. Yes, I haven't done this in a few weeks, but you know what time it is. It's time to enter into the presence of the Lord in this place and worship and exalt Him, for He is worthy of all praise and honor. So whether you're in here with us this morning or you're watching on Facebook, let's set aside this time as we enter into the presence of the Lord and worship Him, because He is worthy. Let's go.
Good morning, Trinity family. Oh, it's so good to be back with you live. I was with you live watching at home sometime, but it's not the same as being here. Those of you who are watching at home on Facebook, I'm glad that you're able to join in with us. But we're here to worship the Lord this morning and to make a joyful noise unto Him. And we're excited. We are excited to be here with you. We want to lift up Jesus in this place. You know, the Bible says that He's the author and the finisher of our faith. He starts us off and He finishes up. Amen. Let's stand. Father in heaven, oh God, how we love You. We just want to give You praise and honor and glory this morning. We want to exalt Your name in this place. We want You to be glorified in here today, whether in the sanctuary or in people's homes. God, be glorified. Just ask that You would, Your grace and mercy would be here this morning. Lord, we want to worship You from our innermost being in here. And God, we just pray that our praises would arise to You, would be a sweet-smelling aroma to You. You've been so good to us, Father. You're a good, good Father. Saints, help me here. God is good, and all the time. Yes, He is. Bless His holy name. The Holy Spirit, be with us now. Be with us now, Holy Spirit, as we enter in to the almighty presence of the living God. that we would join our voices together. And God, it would be a sound that you love to hear. And we'll be faithful to give you the praise and honor and glory for it. In Jesus' mighty name, God's people said, let's worship.
Messiah still, and all the praise the name.
Oh, praise the name of the Lord our God. No, praise His name forevermore. For endless days we will sing Your praise. No, Lord, oh Lord our God.
And on the third,
is that not good? Listen, this altar is always open for you to come. For whatever reason, if you need prayer, there'll be someone to come down here to pray with you. You know, sometimes it takes a little humility, humbling yourself, to come. That's what God wants us to do, is to humble ourselves. And so if there's something going on you need prayer for, whatever it is, know that this altar is here. And that's not the only way you're going to receive an answer to prayer. But if God is touching your heart now in some way, as we continue to worship, you come. You come. And bow before the King of Kings. And let someone pray with you. Amen.
song, God, how we love your name. Jesus, you're the beautiful one. We love your name. How we love your name, Jesus, you're the beautiful one.
How we love you, Lord.
exalted, forever exalted, and I will praise His name. He is the Lord, forever His truth shall reign. Heaven and earth rejoice in
thing that we know, Jesus, is that you are on your throne. One thing that we know is that you are seated. The work is complete. That our citizenship is with you, Jesus. We're living for another age, God. You are our hope. You are our peace. And you reign on high. There is no one above you. There's no one besides you who can compare to you, God. Is there anyone who is like you, Jesus? Is there anyone? Is there anyone? You are exalted, King, you're exalted. You are exalted, King, you're exalted. You
Jesus, you're worthy. Oh God, how worthy are you, oh God. Jesus, there is nothing else like your presence. We long for the moments that we get to sit and glean from you, God. Oh, Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth just as it is in heaven. Oh, God, give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us of our debts as we forgive those who have debts against us, God. Thank you, Jesus, for your dwelling presence, oh God. God, we lift up your name, God. You are exalted, King of kings, Lord of lords. You are crowned king forever, God. You reign eternally, Jesus. You are the Ancient of Days. You are the Rock of Ages, God. And we give you our praise. We give you our worship, God. We boast in you and you alone. God, you are worthy. You are worthy, Jesus. The Lamb who was slain, God, for our sins, Jesus. No longer are they counted against us, God. You removed them from us as far as the east is from the west, God. And we give you praise for that, Jesus. We give you glory. We give you honor, God. And if you don't do another thing, just as we studied in Sunday school this morning, God, we are content, God, with who you are, Jesus. We're content with what you've done for us thus far, God. If you don't do another thing, God, we thank you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. We glorify your name, oh God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, God. God, we thank you for your word, oh God. Your word convicts us. It instructs us. It encourages us, God. It edifies us, Jesus. God, do that in us, God, today. Do that in your body today, Father God. God, I thank you for the man of God that you've sent unto us to deliver your word unto us, Father. God, I thank you that you have anointed him, God, with your anointing, Father God. God, I thank you that your power will go forth through your word, God, and it will accomplish what you have set it out to accomplish, Father, and it will not return unto you void. And Satan, we come against you right now. We know your schemes, we know your plans, but your plans will not be accomplished in this place. There are angels that are guarded around us, Father God, and I thank you for your angels that are encamped around us, Father God. God, I thank you for your hedge of protection that surrounds this body, Father. And I thank you, Father God, that every plan and every scheme, God, will be fretted in the name of Jesus, Father God. It will be brought down in the name of Jesus. And I thank you right now, Father God, that for what you are doing in us and what you are doing through us, Father God. Continue to work out your perfect work in us, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we give you the praise, honor, and the glory now and forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good morning again. My goodness. Let me go over a few announcements here before we get started. This evening, we're having our fall festival, and really we're just kind of doing that for our church family. In years past, we've sometimes had thousands of people out back. This is kind of for our own church family tonight. And that's between 5 and 7 p.m. Katie still needs some helpers, workers. And if you're in a position to do that, at 2 o'clock, she would like you to be here to help set up tables and games and different things. It's going to be a fun time. There's going to be a chili cook-off. She asked me the other day if I would be willing to be a judge on the chili cook-off, and I said yes, but with one exception, that you supply me with some Rolaids. Seriously, there's some good chili and there's some bad chili.
So hopefully I get to taste the good chili. But that's this evening between 5 and 7. And if home groups, different home groups have been assigned different tables to work tonight. And so if you're in a home group and you haven't been notified about that, contact your home group leader and they'll let you know what table. And if you're going to be here working a table, try to be here by 4:30 to get some instructions. But workers need to be here at 2 this afternoon. And also, those of you that might park out back after church is over, if you'll make sure you move your cars. I know sometimes you go to lunch and leave your cars there till you get back. But we need everything out of the back parking lot where we can put our games and stuff, okay? So 2 o'clock, helpers come and get set up. 5 o'clock to 7, we'll have our chili cook-off and our games. Move your cars out of the back. This Wednesday is home groups. If you're not in a home group, we would love for you to be in a home group. Even those of you that might be watching online, if you want to get plugged into our body here, we would love to hear from you. If you have anything that you would need prayer for, or we are here, all you have to do is call the office and we'd be glad to visit with you and get you plugged into things here in our ministry. So that's this Wednesday. Last thing I want to say, this coming Tuesday is a national election. Happens every 4 years. We're in a time in our nation that we need to pull together as God's people. I am not here to tell you how to vote, who to vote for. But I do ask you that you would prayerfully consider, if you haven't already voted, first thing is go vote. My goodness, we have a privilege in this nation, freedom to be able to go vote for whoever leads our nation. So take advantage of that and go vote. But prayerfully consider the different people that are running for the different offices. Look at what they stand for and what they've voted for in the past. And let the Holy Spirit show you which ways would be best for this nation to go. So that's, go vote, okay? It doesn't take but a few minutes, so just go vote and know that you have fulfilled, I believe, an obligation that each one of us have to vote in this election. Okay. Jody, if you want to put that scripture up there, if y'all would stand and read this with me. See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, redeeming the time because the days are evil. One more time. See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, redeeming the time because the days are evil. Amen. Be seated. So, what does that word circumspectly mean? Man, that's a big word. Got a lot of letters in it. What it means, several meanings, in the context here, walk circumspectly means to be cautious, be diligent, be careful, be watchful. That's a definition of it. And so I've entitled the message today, Watch Your Step. Watch your step. I'm excited about this. I believe the Lord showed me, and you know, I want to thank our elder board and our staff and y'all for allowing me to be off this past month. I really initially didn't want to do that. I'll be honest with you. I thought, too much. But as the days and weeks went by, I could see how God used that in my life and with my wife.
time that we've had together that was really probably best time that we've had. And so thank you. I needed that when I didn't know I needed it. You know what I mean? So watch your step. How we walk in life affects us physically as well as spiritually. Now, you gotta get the understanding here that in the natural, I'm going to be talking about how we walk. But also in the spirit, it makes a difference how we walk also. So how we go through life, how we walk affects us physically as well as spiritually. Now sometimes physically, we need help walking. You know, 5 years ago, when I went through some major physical problems, I needed help physically walking. I was on crutches, I was on a cane, I was on a walker, I was even in a wheelchair for a while. I needed help. There's some of you in here today that need help getting around, but one day he's not going to need that chair. Is that right? That's right. But there's just things that cause us to have to use something to help us walk. The same thing applies spiritually. Spiritually, we need the Holy Spirit to help us walk. You know, Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 said, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your understanding, but acknowledge him in all his ways, and he will direct your path." That word direct means make smooth or make straight. He will make the rough edges smooth and the crooked ways straight. So we need help physically walking sometimes as well as spiritually. And so we need to pay attention where we step so that we don't fall. You know, having gone through some things I have in recent years, I don't walk as good now as I used to years ago because of new knees, that my knees don't hurt anymore, but new knees don't give you the same ability that you used to have. Is that right, Mike Washington? That's right. Paul Tankersley? They know what I'm talking about. But spiritually, we need to walk in a way that we don't fall into temptation. The Galatians 5:16 says that if we walk in the Spirit, we'll not fulfill the lust of the flesh. So walking in the Spirit will keep us from fulfilling the lust of the flesh. I feel like the Lord wanted to speak a word to somebody this morning. And this is what I believe he spoke to my spirit. I don't know if it's somebody in here or if it's somebody watching online. I don't know if it's a man or a woman. But I believe God's got a word for somebody that what this has to do about watching your step. And I believe he's speaking it to someone that is a believer, that has been saved, that has even walked with God closely at one time. But because of situations and circumstances in life, things have gone bad, whether physically, spiritually, emotionally, financially, it's caused you to get out of step with God. And the Lord wants you to know this morning, wherever you are, and it might be more than one person, but I know specifically for one, that all you have to do is say, "God, I need help." There was a lady who used to minister here years ago, Mom Workman, missionary in Haiti. She had a song that said, "Throw out the lifeline." God's telling you this morning to throw out that lifeline and he's going to pull you in, and he's going to get you back into a walk with him. Not necessarily like you had before, but even better. So if that speaks to your heart, just know that God is speaking to you, and he wants to do something in your life that is good. Amen. Proverbs 28:18 says, whoever walks blamelessly will be saved, but he who is perverse in his ways will suddenly fall. That blamelessly doesn't mean we never make a mistake or stumble. Let me just tell you. We all have times that we might fall into temptation or fall into a sin. But that's what the blood of Christ did for us, that he cleanses us. Is that if we confess our sins, he's faithful to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. We wouldn't make it without blood. It's the lifeline. So these last few weeks, I hadn't been here day-to-day activities. I've stopped by every now and then, and I've been told to leave, so kind of hurt my feelings. But I appreciate the staff for being able to cover for me, my brother Sam, and others to take care of things that I might normally do. I appreciate that. And I got to do a little fishing and got to do a little hunting and got to spend a lot of time with my lovely wife, Susan. And some of the things that we did, we've never done before as a married couple. And she just surprised me because she was interested in doing some things that we talked about. I thought, that's kind of out of context. One day we got the kayaks, and we went down to Lake Catherine State Park and went kayaking. She'd never been in a kayak. And to be honest with you, I was really a little reluctant because I just knew she was going to flip over, and that water right now is pretty cool. She did good. She didn't flip over, and she enjoyed it, wants to do it again. We went on some drives. We went up to Queen Wilhelmina State Park and walked some trails up there. We went to, what's that one up by Dardanelle? Where? Not Nebo. Yes. Thank you. See, I have to write notes down sometimes. I don't remember what I'm saying. We went there first, and then we walked some trails there. They wasn't too bad. But then we got to Queen Wilhelmina, and I guess I'd been there long, long time ago. I don't remember, but it was a hike up that road to even get up there. And so we got up there, and we pulled up to the lodge thing, and we were going to walk some trails. They had several different trails, so we were walking up to the trailhead. You know, they had a couple different signs, and this one sign, I thought it said, because I was looking from the distance, I thought it said Lover's Lane, the trail. I thought, yeah. Well, I could see me just holding hands and walking with my wife and maybe getting a little kiss. But as I got closer, I realized it didn't say Lover's Lane. It said Lover's Leap. And I thought, I don't know if we want to walk on this trail or not. But we did. And it was a lot more difficult than the other one we went to. I mean, it was rough. There was rocks. You had to go up. You had to go down, go around trees, go over logs. It was a little bit more than what we bargained for. We had to watch our steps. Because one misstep, we could have rolled down. And we had to hold on to things as we were walking. Like it'd be a tree or a bush, we'd have to hold on to it to step down or pull ourselves up. We had to hold on to each other, pull each other up or down. We had to hold on to each other. We had to watch our step. You know, as believers, we need to take the same caution and not blow through life spiritually. Just like that trail, we couldn't just take off walking at a normal pace because we would have fallen. We had to be careful. So as believers, if you would, turn over to Ephesians 4, verse 1. It says, therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, I therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you to walk, what? Worthy of the calling with which you were called, with all lowliness and gentleness, with longsuffering, bearing with one another in love, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. That's the way that Scriptures tell us that how we're to walk. Walk worthy of the calling with which we've been called. And we only can do that, saints, like I said before, by the power of the Holy Spirit leading us and guiding. You know, the Holy Spirit is also called the Paraclete, which means one who comes alongside. He goes before us and comes behind us. The Holy Spirit is what we need to help us get through life. Now, there is some expectations that God has for us, how we're to live life. There is some expectations. Flip over to Romans, if you would. Romans 13. Apostle Paul writes here in verse 13, let us walk what? Mine says properly, which means decently, as in the day, not in revelry and drunkenness, not in lewdness and lust, not in strife and envy, but put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to fulfill its lust. Walk properly. So in the natural, we're having to walk properly, carefully, circumspectly. You know, and for most of us, when we're just walking, like I'm walking right now, I'm not watching where my feet are going. I'm on flat. I'm okay. All of you can do the same thing. But if I start to go down here, I've got to be careful. Because my body just doesn't want to do that much anymore. I've got to take one step at a time. You remember back in school, you're going to school, and if you had stairs at your school, you'd run up those steps, skip a step or two going up or down? Mm-mm. Can't do that. So we're to walk properly in the Spirit. And then if you would, turn over to Micah in the Old Testament, Prophet Micah, 6th chapter. Now, like I said, these are some expectations that God has for us, how we're to walk. Micah 6:8, he says, he has shown you, O man, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you but to do justly, to love mercy, and to walk what? Humbly with your God. So that's an expectation that God has for us, that we would do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly before God. Saints, we need to really concentrate on our walk with God. And we need to count on the Holy Spirit to give us the grace that we need to be able to walk humbly and to do justly and to love mercy. You know, we were talking in Sunday school this morning. We were in Ephesians. Paul, at the end of his life, the Apostle Paul, the great man of God, here he was at the end of his life. He's saying he's already been poured out like a drink offering, which in the day the pagans of that time, they would pour oil and wine on someone's head that was getting ready to be sacrificed. Paul wasn't being sacrificed by the Romans. He was a living sacrifice, as we all are in Christ. But he knew his time was up. And he goes on to say, "But I have fought the good fight of faith. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith." Paul walked with God. And it wasn't an easy walk, was it, if you read the epistles? This guy was mistreated, misused, beaten, left for dead. But it didn't shake him, didn't cause him to leave his walk with his God. Now, I was telling the class this morning, I don't know, especially one town that he went to, and they stoned him and left him for dead. And he didn't die. And the next thing you read is he got up and went back into the same town. I told them I'd be heading for the county line, I'm afraid. You know, obviously I wore out my welcome. But he ran his race to the very end. And I want to encourage you, saints. We all have different struggles and trials in life that want to try to pull us away from a relationship and a walk with God. Don't let go of that. Don't get pulled off in a way that's going to cause you to miss your step spiritually. God has so much for each one of you in here, each one of you watching at home. God's got more for you than you can even imagine. It's just a matter if we want to be submitted to Him and humble ourselves and walk with Him. Watch your step. In Ephesians 5 and 2, He tells us to walk in love. Wow. How much do we do that? Especially for people that have done things to us, hurt us, said things about us. How easy is it for us to love those? Not easy. But the Word of God says that we're to love each other. In fact, Jesus made it real clear. He said the two most important things that you can do is to love God and to love, help me, people. Loving God is easy. We love God. We're in here worshiping, loving God here this morning. What happens sometimes when we walk out of these doors to the car? Somebody says something or doesn't say something. How much love has been shown then? Walk in love. Also in Ephesians 5:8, it says we're to walk as children of the light. The Bible says that as Christians, we're the light of the world. And in 1 John, it says, as he is in the light, walk in the light. Speaking of Jesus. All these ways that the Bible tells us to walk, we only can do it by the Spirit of God, because our flesh is not going to want to obey. I promise you. Some of you do a good job, but there's still times when we don't. So it's by the Spirit of God and His grace that enables us to be able to fight the good fight, to finish the race, and to keep the faith. So how can we walk circumspectly before the Lord? How can we do that? Tells us to do it. How does that happen? It happens by the power of the Holy Spirit. That's how we're able to do it. It's not a man-made thing. It's not a list of rules that we can't keep them. It's by the Spirit of God that lives within us. And you know, the Spirit of God that lives within, I like this. The Spirit of God that lives within, the Scripture says, it's the same Spirit that raised Christ Jesus from the dead, rules and reigns in our mortal body. It's not some different Spirit. It's the same Spirit, the Spirit of Christ Jesus, living within us, gives us that power to do that. If you'll turn back over to Ephesians, 5th chapter. So we've talked about, see then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise. So that's what we've been talking about, how to walk and what will enable us to walk, what will help us physically as well as spiritually. But then he says, redeeming the time because the days are evil. Redeeming the times because the days are evil. What does Paul mean by that? You know, we have a thinking about redemption, redeeming, like pop bottles. Keep your pop bottles and take them back and you get a nickel or whatever. Bottle caps, green stamps. I don't even know if they have green stamps anymore, but you would save those stamps. You'd take them back to the S&H store and pick you something off the shelf. That was redeeming. That's not used in this context. What Paul's talking about here is redeem the time, is making the best use of every opportunity for the grace of God to be there. In other words, as we're living this life, we're to make every opportunity, take every opportunity to flow in the grace of God and the opportunities that He gives us. You know, I've got a saying that all of you have heard over the years that, what is that saying, Sam? Divine opportunities. Come on, man, I need some help here. Golly, I've only been gone a month. Divine opportunities. Every day, God gives us an opportunity to minister, to be a blessing, to do something. Even as simple as opening a door for someone, shaking someone's hand, saying hello, catch the elevator door for them, or actually ask them if we can pray for them. You know, we are in a new season as church, and not just Trinity, but the church, and especially this nation. Because there's more people watching church services online than there are actually attending in the building these days. And, you know, people are saying that this is the new thing. This is where it's going to be. And so we've been talking about different ways to be able to reach people that are online that might be watching. A couple weeks ago, Matt and I went to eat at a restaurant, and the server, as we were talking, we had known her from the past, she let us know that her and her mother watch the service online and how it so blesses them because they're not able to come physically to a service. But watching it online and how much that meant to them. And so we had an opportunity that day to ask her if we could pray for her. And she was so blessed that we would even ask that, take that opportunity. See, saints, that's a divine opportunity. Sam has divine opportunities every Tuesday, well, not just Tuesdays, but especially on Tuesdays, with our food pantry and people that come to the food pantry. And he takes those opportunities to minister in whatever way it is. Each one of us, every day, we have an opportunity to be a blessing to someone. It's just a matter of whether or not we want to move in that. They're there, but do we want to seize the moment? And do we want to allow God to use us in some way to minister to somebody? And it's not having to get your Bible out and start quoting scriptures. I mean, just be friendly. Smile at some. Of course, you can't see smiles anymore. Somehow or another, you got to try to read their eyes instead of the mouth. We can't see the mouth anymore. I'm not going to say something right there. So, redeeming the time. Take every opportunity to get the most out of grace and God-ordained opportunities. Let me say that again. To make the most out of the times of grace and God-ordained opportunities. You know, the thing about it, saints, they may never come again. That opportunity that you had in that moment may never come around again. I know over the years, man, I've missed a lot of opportunities. Before being saved and after being saved, I've missed a lot of opportunities. And some of them never came around again. And people had died and went on, and I don't really know the condition of their heart at the time. But I had an opportunity that I could have gone seen them. But I had other things to do. God have mercy. Don't waste the time that God has given you. Watch your step. Because he says the days are evil. Now, he's talking about the current time back then in Rome, which they were evil. You know, this guy named Nero, he was killing Christians. And, you know, the historians say that Paul was beheaded. And so it was a dangerous time. They were in persecution. They had to scatter from their homes. You know, we're living in times, evil times right now. The days are evil. Christians are being persecuted. We've always thought that to be in third world countries, which it is. But even here in America now, things that are going on is coming against our Christian liberties. People in Africa are being killed because of their faith, beheaded. Days are evil. And
Saints, the truth is that shouldn't take us by surprise, because Jesus talks about it in the Gospel of Matthew, that in the last days, these things are going to happen. And I think we're seeing some of those. I'm not saying, you know, nobody knows the day or time. Jesus doesn't even know. But I believe there's birth pangs going on, that's for sure. The days are evil. All the more reason that we need to walk circumspectly, cautiously, diligently, watchfully, making sure how we walk as Christians. Because it's not so much what we say to people that they're going to hear. They're going to look how we live. But are we able to walk in a way that backs up our talk? Are we able to walk as children of the light? And God has made provisions that we can do that because of His grace, His mercy, and His loving Holy Spirit gives us an opportunity to be able to walk carefully and cautiously. Because we have an enemy that wants, and Jesus tells us in John 10:10, the thief cometh but to steal, kill, and destroy. Every one of you as a Christian, that's the devil's purpose and plan, to steal, kill, and destroy. I have watched him do this in people's lives over the years. I have watched him do this, unfortunately, many times. People that were on fire for the Lord, walking with God, and things took place in their life, and the devil came in, and they have no relationship with God anymore. It's sad. But that's what his purpose is. But Jesus didn't just leave it right there. He said, but I have come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. That's what Jesus came to do, that we may have life, and not just life, but more abundantly. So are you living in that abundant life? You can be. You can be. Let me finish up with this scripture in 1 John. 1 John 1. Apostle John writing this. 1 John 1:5. This is the message which we have heard from him and declare to you, that God is light and in him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not practice the truth. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. If we walk in the light as he is the light, we have fellowship with him. So I encourage you, saints, take time to think about your walk. See, these last few weeks, man, I've had a lot of time to think and to pray and read. And I want to make sure that I'm trying to do what I need to do to walk uprightly before the Lord and not waste time. Not waste time. Because we never know when our last breath is going to be. We don't have assurance of tomorrow. So let's make the most out of today. We take every opportunity that the grace of God gives us to minister, to be a light. Father,
God, I just thank you. Lord, I thank you for your love that you have for each one of your children, and that you are no respecter of persons. Nobody has an advantage over anybody else in your kingdom. So God, we just thank you for our time this morning. Lord, I thank you for being able to worship you in this place, in this assembly. Lord, I thank you for your word that's truth. Your word is truth, God. And Lord, I just ask that you would help each one of us, God, to examine ourselves. God, help us to examine ourselves and be honest with ourselves. And God, that you would help us to pursue you with all of our heart. With all of our heart, God, we would pursue you. Now, God, I pray a blessing over everyone that's here in this room, everyone at home, wherever they are on Facebook. God, I pray that you would bless, that you would bring healing and deliverance from anybody. God, that you would minister to people in a way that only you can do. And Lord, that you would encourage your people. God, that we would continue to fight the good fight. That we would finish the race that we started, and that we would keep the faith. And we give you praise and honor and glory for it. In Jesus' mighty name, God's people said, amen. Don't forget this evening, a fall fest, 5 to 7. Workers need to be here at 2 o'clock. If you have cars in the back parking lot, please move them where we can put games up. Amen. Let's go home.